Det er søndag. Gud så.
Fing væk.
Fingerne væk.
Det er
fingerne væk.
B.O.U.
Fingerne væk. Sikker fjernsyn.
Goddag. Det er igen et mega godt program fra B.O.U.
Fingerne væk. Det er søndag.
Ja, hvis det ikke allerede er skåret ud i pap, så handler fingrene væk denne gang om typer, om images, eller kan man skue hunden på hårene.
Og vi har inviteret Lars på 19 i studiet. Bag ved den her dør, der sidder der tre piger, som Lars aldrig før har set i sit liv. Det eneste pigerne har til fælles er, at de er sproglige piger fra IKAST Gymnasium. Om et øjeblik, så åbner vi døren, og så skal Lars udelukkende på baggrund af, hvordan pigerne ser ud, vælge, hvem af dem han helst vil være sammen med fredag aften. Er du klar, Lars?
Jo.
Vær så god. Og her er tre søde piger, og vi vil ikke høre en lyd fra pigerne her. Det er meget vigtigt. Det er kun på grundlag af udseende, at Lars nu tager stilling og vælger en af pigerne.
Lad os sige midten.
Du tager pigen i midten, ja. Og alle har set det. Og nu lukker vi så dørene igen. Værsgo. Og Cecilie og Mette går nu om på den anden side af dørene her og bytter rundt på pigerne, giver dem et skilt på hver A, B og C. Og det, der skal ske nu, Lars, det er, at du nu på grundlag af dine egne spørgsmål og deres svar skal finde ud af, hvem der passer bedst til dig. Og denne gang er det altså ikke på grundlag af deres udseende. Nu er det kun ved hjælp af dine spørgsmål. Og du må selvfølgelig ikke spørge om deres udseende. Det er det eneste, du ikke må spørge om. Alt andet må du spørge om. Og du får sådan en lille blok her. Så kan du sidde og notere ned.
I tak.
Er I klar derom?
Ja,
vi er klar, ja.
Godt. Og så får du en små 5 minutter. Vi afbryder det, når vi synes, at
tiden er gået.
Ja.
Okay.
Værsgo.
Begynd noget, som jeg synes er vigtigt. A. Hvad for noget musik kan du lide?
Jeg kan godt lide Level 42 og Depeche Mode og Erasure. Altså noget med noget rytme, noget man kan danse til.
Okay, det vil sige moderne musik. Du kan overhovedet ikke lide klassisk musik?
Jo, altså bare sidde og lytte til sådan. Det er meget rart.
Okay, det vil sige, det er ikke en interesse hos dig?
Nej.
C, hvad med dig? Hvad for noget musik kan du lide?
Jeg kan lide Dire Straits og The Beatles kan jeg også godt lide, og Shubidua og Gasoline. Dansk musik, det kan jeg meget godt lide.
Okay. Se, nu kan jeg ikke huske, om jeg sagde B eller C.
C.
C. Okay, så må jeg hellere sige B nu.
Jeg kan lide næsten alt musik.
Næsten alt musik?
Altså, hvis det er noget, jeg skal sidde og lytte til derhjemme, så er det næsten lige meget hvad. Bare ikke sådan noget heavy metal eller sådan noget. Det er jeg ikke så vild med.
Okay. Det er jo positivt. Det vil sige, der er faktisk ingen af der sådan er specielt sådan med klassisk musik, og heller ikke specielt poppet. Okay. Noget andet. Sådan A. Ryger du?
Ja, det sker.
Det sker? Okay.
Kan vi få at vide, hvor mange om dagen?
Jeg ryger ikke hver dag. Altså, jeg ryger, når jeg er i byen, og så samtidig sådan, når jeg har lyst.
Okay. hvad med dig, B? Du er måske også en fanatisk anti-ryger.
Jeg ryger aldrig.
Aldrig?
Kun ned ad trapperne.
Det kommer simpelthen ikke. Det er selvfølgelig okay for lungerne. Hvad med C?
Nej, jeg ryger heller ikke.
Du ryger heller ikke?
Nej.
Uha. Okay. Hvad A? Er du et sportsmenneske?
Ja, det ved jeg ikke. Jeg spiller volleyball på den skole, hvor jeg går på, og spiller håndbold i fritiden.
Håndbold og volleyball?
Ja.
Okay. Skal vi se. Det var A. Og hvad med dig, B?
Jeg dyrker meget gymnastik.
Sådan noget hop rundt på et gulv og lave alt muligt ting.
Det er en fonde workout.
Ja, simpelthen.
Eller hvad?
Det er... Ja, sådan...
Redskabsgymnastik eller...
Ja, både med og uden redskaber og spring.
Med og uden redskaber. Uha. Hvad med C?
Ja, jeg svømmer hver uge, men ellers dyrker jeg overhovedet ikke noget sport.
Så du er en vandhund?
Ja.
Der kan man bare se. Nu har vi dækket sådan rimelig meget. Hvad kan I lide? Ja. A, kan du lide at gå i byen?
Ja, det kan jeg
du
godt.
Du kan godt lide at gå ud og danse og sådan noget.
Eps.
Det sidste der, det hørte jeg næsten ikke.
Hvad for noget?
Det sidste, du sagde der, det
kunne jeg ikke. Jeg sagde, ja, jeg kan godt lide at gå i byen.
Okay. Hvad med B?
Hvis jeg har råd til det.
Hvis du har råd til det?
Ja, så kan jeg godt.
Åh, du har måske ikke nogen penge sådan til daglig. Det er jo klart, det er klart minus.
Det, jamen, det er klart du giver vel den aften i byen, ikke Lars?
Gør jeg det?
Ja, det ved jeg ikke.
I betaler?
Nej.
Og hvad med C?
Jo, jeg kan godt lide at gå i byen, men det er ikke noget, jeg dyrker særlig meget.
Det er ikke noget, du dyrker særlig meget. Hvad... når du går i byen og sådan noget, hvad plejer det? Hvor plejer du sådan... Diskoteker eller private fester eller...
Ja, jeg plejer at gå på diskotek sammen med nogen.
Sådan en helt masse mennesker ud og bumle?
Nej, ikke nødvendigvis en hel masse. Bare nogle stykker, så.
Bare sådan... Okay, få udvalgte venner.
Ja. Ja, så har du et spørgsmål tilbage, så er det sket.
Et spørgsmål tilbage.
Så du må tænke dig grundigt om nu.
Okay.
Det altafgørende spørgsmål her før valget, det endelige valg.
Og må jeg spørge noget om skolen, så? Det er jo vigtigt. Hvordan har du det med skolen og sådan noget?
Sådan, hvordan jeg har det med det?
Ja, går det godt i skolen, eller er du skoletræt, eller... Ja, simpelthen sådan skolen i almindelighed.
Men jeg kan godt lide at gå i skole.
Du kan godt lide at gå i skole?
Ja.
Du er overhovedet ikke skoletræt og sur på din lærer eller noget som helst?
Det kan da ikke undgås en gang imellem, så sagde
jeg. Okay. Hvad med B?
Frikvartererne, de er meget gode.
Okay, du er simpelthen ikke...
Jeg har ikke noget at gå i skole.
Det må jeg så lige få ned her.
Ja.
Så jeg mangler lige en person.
Okay.
Hvad med dig, C?
Jeg nyder at gå i skole. Jeg kan godt.
Du nyder at gå i skole? Skal vi se. Nu er summen sammen her.
Ja, de 5 minutter er jo gået i hvert fald. Så...
Ja, men nu skal jeg lige lægge sammen og trække fra.
Skal lige have altså, en chance
for... Ja, sådan gennemgå det her, ikke?
Det gør du stille og roligt.
Mens pigerne sidder i spændt forventning.
Ja, det vil jeg se.
Hvem af dem bliver den udkårende?
Ja, jeg må jo nok sige, at A, det lyder nu meget okay, altså.
Hvem tror du A?
Hvem tror du A?
Det er det samme, som du valgte før.
Har du nogen idé om det?
Det skulle ikke undre mig, hvis det ikke var det, men det kunne godt være det.
Skal vi ikke åbne
det? Det kunne godt være den samme.
Lad os se.
Værsgo.
Okay, næsten. Tæt på. Ja. Hvor går du hen?
Hvor jeg vil.
Ja. Hun er optaget fredag aften. Det.
Thank you. And here we are, everybody. Greetings from LA.
What do you think about Eurythmics putting a special show on just for the Tube?
I think it's brilliant.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Country Club. Tonight is a very special evening. One of the greatest contemporary bands is about to start its world tour in certainly the smallest venue it can play over the next year. They're very nervous. I hope that you give them a huge welcome. They're friends of mine, and they're doing this as a treat for all their Los Angeles fans and the viewers of the Tube. I know them as a bunch of old tossers. They're probably more familiar to you as Eurythmics!
Yeah.
You have to keep changing how you look all the time now because people are rather expecting it. Or do you? Have you always done that?
I'm a little bit. It's funny, I'm a little bit. Like if people start to expect me to change, then I sort of want to put my heels in and say, well, I'm not going to change. You know, I'll do. And if it starts to be my little label that I change, I think that's really predictable. So I really always just want to do what I think is good and avoid what I think is really cliched and hackneyed and boring. So it's really, whatever other people think, you can't live up to other people's expectations. You just have to have your own. And I have my own about myself and about Eurythmics. Dave and I have our ideas. Although we don't always agree, we usually come to a good result in the end.
Do you ever have rows with her about how things should be done?
Terrible, yeah. Really bad rows. But about things that other people would think are really ridiculous for arguing about, you know. We don't have rows about the big major things. It's like, for instance, just the other day in this video edit, Annie wanted some doors to open like this and I wanted them to open with a handle. That went up for half an hour, you know.
How much are the videos your ideas and how much input do you put into them
I would say that really Dave has a lot to do with the initial ideas for stories or not having a story or whatever we plan to do. It really sort of comes from Dave, with little odd bits and pieces put in by me. And then I often sort of have ideas on set and I often have ideas in the edit as well. So it gets mixed up the more it progresses.
When you were about 17?
Yes.
Elton signed you. And lived to regret it.
Yeah, he did, but the thing is, I didn't realise what we were meant to do. And so he gave our group an advance of money and...
How much?
I can't remember, it was a bit vague. But I know that we spent the lot very quickly. And when John Reed and Elton John asked, you know, here what the recordings we were doing, we hadn't made any yet. He was saying, what record? He didn't really understand what being in a group was, I know that. But we learned very quickly.
And did you think the advance was sort of spend?
We thought it was just, well, I invited all my friends down from Sunderland. I had about 12 people from Sunderland come down and I bought acoustic guitars and we bought all sorts of illegal substances and things and went mad for about 6 months.
And then the crunch came.
And then the crunch
what
came.
What did they do? What did Elton and John Reed do when there was nothing? No record.
I think they realised pretty soon after they signed us that we were very naive. And so they tried to help us, you know, took us on tour to Italy. It's funny because I remember singing backing vocals to Elton with Kiki D. I think they were wondering what they could do with us, you know, so we ended up like singing backing vocals. But we were a good group, like an acoustic group, but we just were very, very naive.
So you were a sort of folk singer?
Yeah. Still am, in my spare time.
Are there any... other women songwriters that you do admire and listen to?
Yeah. Well, Chrissy Hynde.
Yeah.
Totally, I think. She was, she's a friend of mine. I've become friends with her. And I think a few years ago, she really helped me. I mean, she didn't know me, but just by listening to her records and the whole sort of character, caliber of what she wrote made a lot of difference to me. It sort of set a standard for me, in a way, as another woman. Initially, it was Joni Mitchell, really. She was the first person who was doing what I wanted to do, ultimately, which was writing songs that expressed how she felt about things and singing them and recording them herself. And she, doing it in a incredibly articulate way at the time. And then... Debbie Harry also influenced me a lot because I think visually she presented things in such an eloquent way that was very contemporary. She was unique. And I was very sad when Blondie sort of went into a kind of demise. That really saddened me because I thought they had a lot longer to go and they never really fulfilled what they could, their own potential.
Do you find that you feel under pressure to do things very different each album or do you find it's just happening naturally?
No, I think that's a great relief that I know that we can do things differently each album. What was the pressure before in the other band was trying to repeat the same thing. I think a lot of bands get really fed up of trying to sort of... They've got stuck with an identity and they have to keep churning out things within the same feel of their identity, whereas
We haven't really got an identity, you know. We're one thing one minute and another thing the next, so we always feel completely fresh.
And how did you pick out which musicians you wanted to work with? Were they friends or were they all people you'd admired before?
We'd known a couple before, but we wanted people who were all determined to be front people, so there's like a big battle of egos on stage, so all seven of us are all fighting for their spotlight. No, because we wanted that kind of band, you know? Everybody a front person, not a band with like me and Annie and backing musicians. So Clem as a drummer is a complete sort of exhibitionist. Or he always missing the beat by throwing his sticks in the air and that kind of thing.
usually inspire you to start writing? Or do you just write all the time?
I don't write all the time, and I really wish I did. I tend to do other things and not write. I tend to rehearse and think about other things to do with what we're doing and leave the writing to the last and panic like mad. But what inspires me to write is listening to other people's music and remembering that, oh yeah, that's what you can do, you know.
Do you think you're very romantic?
I think I'm a funny mixture of being very romantic and being very hard, on the other hand, hard on sentimentality and things like that.
Now, you have sort of a tortured love life, don't you?
No.
You do a bit?
Oh, well, a bit.
Are you very romantic?
No, I just like being tortured. No.
Fibber.
Yeah, I am, yeah. I think I am, but I think I'm Woody Allen's a bit romantic, but he always gets things wrong. I'm a bit like that, really.
Now I feel that a lot of my life was looking back, was pretty miserable, and the search for trying to find out who I was, because there was an awful lot of heart-rending search.
Yeah.
And now I really feel like, well, I want to enjoy my life. I don't want to be in pain, you know. I want to feel fulfilled, and I don't want to feel empty and void and miserable. So I now am kind of a little easier on myself.
Dangerous world, every star.